Welcome to an introduction to data journalism. This is for Journalism M02, Digital Media Reporting and Writing at Moorpark College. My name is Professor Kelsey Stewart. What is data journalism? Data journalism is journalism. Data is really just attribution for information. Everyone produces data, and now data is endless. Journalism that uses technology to access, analyze, and find stories in data and then tell the stories of the people the data represents. It's our textbook's definition of data journalism. According to the Bureau of Investigative Journalism, everyone produces data, whether voluntarily or not, and as they use their mobile phones, search the internet, use social media, or even walk down the street. Public bodies are the same. Every day, they are producing data on their staff, their spending, their work, and the product of their choices on our public institutions. The stories of our communities, big and small, are held in this data, and that is why it is crucial for journalists to be able to navigate and interrogate it, to inform the public on the state of their communities, and to unveil systematic wrong when it exists. The search for the truth in endless data. As data has increased in availability, so has the need for more determined techniques for journalists, ones that embrace technology. Truth is the backbone of journalism. Do you know how to find it? The beginning level of data research is public records. Free public records include census data, property information, tax liens and judgments, criminal records, bankruptcies, and court records. Public records are any information or documents that are made by a government agency or officer and are required by law to be kept and maintained. They are also any records that are filed with a government agency or office. Most public records are available to anyone that requests them, but some have eligibility requirements or are confidential. Census data includes birth and death records. Along with marriage license and divorce records, these can all be found at the local county's clerk's office where the event took place. Some states have free databases online, but not all. Criminal records. Some high-profile cases will have access restrictions during their actual proceedings, but the happenings of a courthouse are a matter of public record. Dockets or summaries of a court case and its proceedings are available after the case is closed. Criminal records are also available through courthouse and police records databases, and all can best be found at a local government office or courthouse for free. Property and land records are one of the earliest forms of record keeping. These pertain to public lots, buildings, or establishments and are readily available. If a building or area was commissioned by the city or by any public representative, records of those communications setting up the property as well as the contract terms themselves will be public record. Private house sales and ownership are not subject to public records law, but real estate appraisals done on a property are public record. This is to ensure honesty in sales and negotiations and expectations. County or city assessors typically maintain and provide access to deeds, assessments, and property tax records. As far as government information, any official meeting or elected officials or public representative body of or public representation of bodies is going to be covered by public and record law. This will exclude mayor and governor offices, but this will include city council, school board meetings, town hall meetings, and much more. Government public records are regulated by a federal or state Freedom of Information Act called the FOIA. The FOIA provides that any person has the right to request access to federal agency records or information, except to the extent the records are protected from disclosure by any of the 9 exemptions contained in the laws or by one of the 3 special law enforcement record exclusions. For more information on this, visit the FOIA.gov. If you cannot find the information on your own that should be public, you can submit a request to the FOIA.gov. You have to make sure that you have first exhausted your resources, make sure that the information you are seeking cannot be found at the local level, Secondly, you want to research which government agency you want to request information from. The more specific, the faster you will get what you need. There are more than 100 government agencies. Find the one that you need here at FOIA.gov. Make sure that what you are requesting does not fall under the 9 exemptions to public record. Again, check FOIA.gov for more information. As we communicate more heavily through technology, good data journalism has become even more dependent upon as actual sources. Sources can come in any form now. Public data sets, leaked emails, scanned documents, satellite imagery, and sensor data. However, data can be distorted. According to our text, stage one is think of issues at the point of data collection where not every group is represented, giving a false majority. Stage two is a data processing stage, the cleaning, which involves geocoding, correcting misspelled names, harmonizing categories, or excluding certain data points altogether if they are considered statistical outliers. Stage three is analysis. Think of mistaking correlations with causation or choosing an inappropriate statistic to summarize the data set in question. How does a data journalist reassure the reader that the sources they have used are reliable and that the work done to derive their conclusions are sound? Well, attribution is huge, so make sure that when you are collecting data, you are 100% attributing it to where you received it from. But still, the need for literate programming and data analysis is huge. Not many people know how to write code. In fact, less than 0.5% of the world's population can write, read, or run code, and 70% are male. R Markdown and Jupyter Notebook are two forms of literate programs that involve a transcription, a verbal and written transcription of data analysis. R Markdown provides an authoring framework for data science. It is a file format for making dynamic documents with R. R Markdown is written in an easy-to-write plain text format, and it is simple formatting syntax for authoring HTML, PDF, and MS Word documents. Jupyter Notebook is an open-source web application that allows you to create and share documents that contain live code, equations, visualizations, and narrative text. The uses it includes is data cleaning and transformation, numerical simulation, statistical modeling, data visualization, machine learning, and much more. According to our text in the data handbook, literate program environments are currently a promising means through which data journalists are making their methodologies more transparent and accountable. While data will always remain open to multiple interpretations, technologies that make a reporter's assumptions explicit and their methods reproducible are valuable. They aid in collaboration and open up an increasingly technical discipline to scrutiny from various publics. Given the current crisis of trust in journalism, a wider embrace of reproducible approaches may be one important way in which data teams can maintain their credibility. Our M03 Advanced Digital Media Reporting and Writing class will go further into these types of data analysis. The changes to journalistic storytelling. To communicate clearly more than words can. With the emergence of multi-skilled specialist groups within the newsroom, with data and data vid skills prioritized in new recruits. As data journalism has taken off, so has the need for specialized and multi-skilled data journalists. Data vis is data visualization. It is a current trend in the newsroom. We think of mobile first in designing our web pages, so every page has low interactions where there's a high visibility of charts that are usually line or bar, and there's scrolly telling of stories that unfold necessarily as the users scroll down the page. So as you scroll down through your phone, you are more engaged with the goal of keeping your readers reading. There are plenty of data journalist career opportunities. The operations research analysis, for instance, starts at $83,000 with a 26% growth prediction. A computer system analysis starts at $93,000 with a 1.0 growth prediction. A marketing research analyst starts at $63,000 with 20% growth, and a sports statistical analysis starts at $79,000 with 27% growth, according to the U.S. Bureau of Labor Statistics. It is an interesting and specialized field to get into within digital media, and is something that we're going to look further into as we move on to M03. Thank you for tuning in, and I will see you guys in class.